And sleep disturbance is an early marker of youth with sleep issues to be at risk for down the line other mood disorders. Is it going to be a very specific marker? Oh, my kid's having trouble sleeping. He's got bipolar disorder. No, that is not what we're saying. But what we are saying is that, you know, early sleep problems may actually predict problems down the line. If we can have a handle on them early, perhaps we can prevent that. And specific sleep issues are likely reduce the need for sleep, may distinguish the youth from bipolar disorder from other disorders. So insomnia, having difficulty sleeping, as we know, is different from mania-related decreased need for sleep, right? Where a kid isn't even sleepy. And so understanding those differences is very important as well in terms of your differential diagnosis and how you're going to evaluate your patient. Okay, sleep problems can worsen symptoms of bipolar disorder. So let's now talk about, you know, other conditions that are disorders of energetics. Bipolar disorder is a disorder of energetics. And that's how I conceptualize that disorder. It's a mood disorder, but it's a disorder of energetics. So sleep deprivation impairs emotional regulation, lack of sleep, then impacts or exacerbates mood symptoms and perpetuates the manic episode. Insufficient sleep undermines cognitive functioning, then can lead to deficits in neuropsychological tests. We do sometimes sleep-deprived EEGs and sleep-deprived neurocognitive tests to understand this phenomenon, but it is well documented that if you don't get enough sleep, it's going to have an impact on your cognition. And very interestingly, and my buddy Dr. Roger McIntyre will probably talk a lot about this relationship, is that obesity risk increases with short sleep duration and exacerbates medication side effects. So if we're going to treat these kids with second-generation antipsychotics, they're going to be even more teed up for metabolic syndrome and other problems. So if we're going to have to treat their mood symptoms with mood stabilization and medications that actually try to bring them down from a mania, we want them to be optimized for response to that without undue side effects. Sleep disturbance is also associated with co-occurring conditions like comorbidity and bipolar disorder related to, for example, marijuana use. A lot of patients that I see who have experienced their first manic episode and subsequently will use marijuana to help them sleep, to get them down from a manic episode. Many kids will experiment. If they're not effectively mood stabilized, they'll actually try to self-medicate with marijuana. And when that happens, they're teed up for a whole host of other problems, besides a substance use disorder, potentially also psychosis. And so it's very important for us to disentangle the relationship between bipolar disorder and comorbid substance use, chicken and the egg, to understand where did that relationship start. Did the kids use marijuana to try to bring them down from hypomanic or manic symptoms that weren't adequately identified or treated? Sleep loss also signals heightened suicide risk, as we talked about, which is a major concern for bipolar disorder. And insufficient sleep is also tied to impulsivity and risk-taking behavior. So we'll talk to you about that. And for kids, that's super important because guess what they're also learning to do in adolescence? They're learning how to drive. And so, perfect storm, if you can imagine, in terms of risk and morbidity and mortality. And so we have some serious work to do to make sure that we identify these issues early and address them. So sleep disturbance in youth with bipolar disorder, key takeaways: sleep issues often precede and predict bipolar diagnosis. Treating sleep problems can improve emotion and cognition. And targeting sleep disturbance can also alleviate co-occurring conditions like substance use. So if we can adequately treat through mood stabilization these conditions, then maybe kids don't have to resort to self-medicating with other substances.